Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making cheddar chive beer bread. And if you want something a little simpler than that, you can leave out the cheddar and the chives and you will have a simple beer bread and it will taste really good. It's a very simple thing to make. You just start out with some flour, and I've chosen self-rising flour to not have to worry about adding any salt or baking powder or anything like that. We want 3 cups. I have 2 cups here and 1 cup here. So 3 cups of self-rising flour. Next, we're going to add some sugar. This is 1/2 cup sugar. We're going to be stirring this together, but first let's put in our cheddar cheese. This is 3/4 cup of cheddar cheese, and we're just going to put that in. It's sharp and it's finely shredded. And over here, I went out to our herb garden, and these are chives that have regrown from last year. It is fresh growth, and I need about 2 tablespoons. So I just wash these and dry them with paper toweling, and I'm going to take scissors to chop in about what I think would be 2 tablespoons, or it is to your taste. If you like this flavor a lot, you can put more. You could actually leave it out if you don't want the cheddar cheese flavored by anything else. Obviously, you could chop this on a cutting board, but this is less mess. Just scissors, run them under the water pretty much, and that's it. So we have a really pretty blend here. Let's stir that together. And we'll have one more ingredient. And that will be how quick it is to make the cheddar chive beer bread. So I'm sure you know the next ingredient is beer. And I have a 12-ounce bottle of beer sitting over here, ready to go in. And we'll just pour that over the top and around the sides just to get as much incorporated as possible. But we're going to stir. And you don't want to overstir this. Any of these quick breads that you make, just get the dry ingredients moistened, and that will be enough. And you usually stir fairly gently and slowly, so probably I'll need to go away on this. Here's our batter all stirred together, and you can see what it looks like. It's nice and light. And what I have is a loaf pan. I decided to use the Pyrex type. I have a stainless steel type, Revereware, but I really like the way Pyrex browns breads like this. So I'm going to go ahead and use that type, but you may use any kind of loaf pan size dish that you have that's oven proof. And we'll just put our bread dough in. And it's not going to fill all the way up to the top, but this will rise and it's going to give us a lovely loaf of cheddar chive beer bread. And I'll smooth that out a little bit, and these soft breads are famous for rising up in the middle. So I'm going to kind of drag a little from the center toward the two ends and toward the side. Then if it rises up in the middle, maybe it won't be such a large mountain. And if it doesn't work, that's okay too. This goes to a 350-degree oven, and it's going to take about 45 minutes, but I'll be checking probably starting at 30 or even before that. I check all the time just to make sure nothing is burning. So I'll show you the bread when it's done. Now here is the cheddar chive beer bread 40 minutes into the cooking of it. And I told you it would take 45 minutes, but I could see that it's browning up a bit. It's not finished yet. If you do a cake tester, it will come out clean, any part of it, but it needs a little extra treatment. And what we have is 1/4 cup of butter that is melted, and we're going to pour that or spoon that and just drizzle it over the top. This is very crusty. You can see it's it taps if you put a spoon to it. So that is just a little crustier than is desirable. The butter takes care of that, softens it up, and it also tastes good too. Also, we'll run down the side and help you get it out of your loaf pan. So this goes back to the oven, the same temperature, 350 degrees, for 10 minutes. And then we'll bring it out and we'll cool it on a cooling rack. I got my cheddar chive beer bread out of the oven after 8 minutes of soaking that butter in. Then I thought it was just long enough. I took it out of my pan and put it on a cooling rack. Now, if you want to cool this completely, it's going to take probably an hour or so. You might want to eat it when it's hot. And probably a lot of you know that I like to eat my breads hot because I can melt some butter on it. So I'm going to prepare this for tasting and I'll be right back to take a taste. Here's our finished cheddar chive beer bread, and it's nice and crusty, and I have cut 3 pieces here, so I'm going to take one of those onto my plate. Over here I have some butter. I like the end pieces, so I'm going to take the end right here. I get more crust that way. And then I will just take a little bit of this butter. Usually I get way too much butter on here, and it's hot, so you should be able to spread it even though that came straight from the refrigerator. And a little more. I didn't mean to cheat myself out of the butter flavor. Now I will say, as I was cutting this with a bread knife, it was pretty tough to get through the bottom, so it is a very crusty type bread. And that's why we went to the trouble of softening up the top a little bit with butter. But let's see, I'm going for the bottom, which is the crusty part, first. Mmm. You probably can hear this because I feel like I'm crunching away. Flavor is delicious. If you've never had beer bread before and you think beer with bread, doesn't sound right, it is right, particularly with the cheddar cheese and chives. I love it. You don't have to watch me eat the next one. Still chewing on the first one. But I hope you like the recipe, and maybe you can try it, and I certainly hope you like it.